Scott.
Hey, Scott, my name is Sydney. First of all, I want to thank you so much for the podcast. It's been an incredible resource, and it's encouraged me to finally take action myself. But I have a question about my seller account. My product can fall into a couple different categories, and from what I've seen with my competitors, they're split about 33% across three really different categories. So let's just take the garlic storage container. The first seller has it in home and kitchen, because that makes sense. The other put it in sports and outdoors, maybe to grill in the backyard. But the third, it's in a really random category like travel, because maybe they want to use the garlic container to bring nuts and candy onto the airplane. I know it doesn't really make sense, but on that first page of Amazon, it's that third random category that has the top three spots. So does this make any sense, and how should I approach this? Should I pick a category that makes sense, like garlic press goes into backyard or maybe the home and kitchen? Or do my competitors know something I don't know? Thank you so much. Any help on this would be much appreciated. Take care.
Hey, Sydney, thank you so much for the question. I appreciate it. And it's a really good question. I'm going to do my best to give you my thoughts and, you know, my advice on this. And as far as what I would be doing personally, the way that I look at it is most people are searching for a product by a keyword. You guys have probably heard me say that over and over and over again, right? And I'll continue to say it because it's the truth, right? If we go to Amazon and we just broke our garlic press, we're going to go type in garlic press, or maybe we'll say stainless steel garlic press or rubber handle garlic press, right? But you get the idea. We're going to go there and we're going to search for something as soon as we go to Amazon.com. Now, with that being said, once we do that and we come up with the top, let's say 12, right? We're going to go ahead and we're going to choose one. We're going to look at one. We're usually going to go by an image and then we're going to go and look at the title and make sure everything lines up, gets our attention. Boom, we click on it. Now we're into that listing. Now that we're into that listing, we're also into a category, okay? So now that we're in a category, depending on what category that's in, if I do another search, I'm technically going to be searching inside of that category. Okay. But in the very beginning, I was searching on all the categories. When I still believe that if you have a keyword that you're being ranked for, no matter what category you're in, you are going to show up in whatever category you're searching in. Okay. Because yes, you can find products by going searching through categories, but ultimately, if you're ranking for keywords, you're going to come up in keywords. That's why you're finding on that front page that they're showing up for, you know, three different categories, right? So that's actually that proves what I'm saying is true. If you go there and you just search, you know, a base search, you go to Amazon.com, you haven't started searching yet, and you search a keyword and you come up to that first page. And like you're saying, like, you know, there's three different categories that are coming up when you look at the listings, when you drill down into those listings, that's proof that on the first page, there's multiple different categories. So to me personally, I don't think it makes that much of a difference. Now, here's where it does make a difference. If you're going after a bestseller badge, and you want that badge to be on there that says, you know, bestseller in, you know, whatever, a subcategory, because that's really what you're going to be going after. Then what you're going to do is you're going to look at these subcategories and then you're going to see what ones are ranking and kind of like, you know, how they are ranking. And if your BSR is better than the top one in that category, in that subcategory, then you will get a bestseller badge. So I've seen people do that where they'll find a subcategory and that'll be their second category. Okay. And just a little reminder here, you can list your product in most categories. You can list them in multiple categories, at least two. All right. So, you know, by finding that secondary one that you might want to list in, then just go ahead and then just contact seller support. Tell them that you want to keep your current, you know, category, but then you also want to add a second category. And usually they'll approve that within a few hours and you'll be listed in there. But I would, again, probably test this. I would start with the one that makes the most sense. Okay. The one that makes the most sense. And then from there, I would play around with that, see how that goes for a month, let's say. And then if you see that you're not getting traction or that, you know, that you think that if you were in another category, it might make a difference, then I would try that. I don't think that that's the case. I think that that person that did it might just not have known any better. That's personally, I've seen that happen a lot because Amazon will also kind of help you pick that category when you submit it. Because sometimes the category that you go after is kind of not even the category that you're going to be listed in. You just kind of tell it what you think it should be in, and then they'll kind of place you. And then from there, you know, it's up to you to say, well, I didn't really want to be in that category. And then you can contact them and say, I'd rather be in this category. And then they'll usually move you. All right. So I don't necessarily think that your competitors are doing it for any type of advantage. And if they are, then just pay attention to it and try it in the main category that you think is going to be the one that you should be listed in. I think that makes the most sense. And then from there, you can always go into those subcategories as well. But it's all going to come down to keywords. It really is. It comes down to keywords. Your title is your most important spot. And then from there, your back end of your seller's account would be the second. And then the third would probably be the bullets. And then from there would be the description. And then obviously your image is going to be another important part for getting the attention. But being found by the words that are in your listing all starts with your title. All right. And it doesn't matter what category you're in. If someone's doing a search from the very beginning, they are going to search at a broad where now you'll show up no matter what. And even if you're in a category and you do a search, you will also, if you have a keyword that's ranking, you will show up there as well. So it may take some testing, but that's what I would recommend. And hopefully this has been helpful to you. So good luck, and keep me posted on that as well. And just test it, play around with it. But I would go with the one that makes the most sense right now. If you guys want to submit a question, head over to theamazingseller.com/ask, and you can do that. I want to also, again, remind you guys, if you're brand new and this is your first time to the show, I want to welcome you. I love hanging out with you guys. This is just awesome to be able to virtually connect like this. And that's why I love the Ask Scott sessions. But if you are brand new and you're just getting your feet wet and you don't understand the entire process, the entire business model, I would recommend attending one of my live free workshops. This is where I break it down for you in 5 phases: how to pick a market and a product, how to source it, how to do a pre-launch, how to do a launch, how to promote the product, and everything in between. We go over that on a workshop, and we go through every single thing. We also do live Q&A. So if you want to attend one of them, I would love to invite you to the next one, and you can register for the next one by heading over to theamazingseller.com/workshop, and you can register there for an upcoming workshop. Well, hey there. Thank you so much for listening to that episode of Ask Scott. Now, that was just a highlight from one of our full episodes where I generally answer 3 to 4 questions on a podcast. If you want to go back and listen to all of the past archives of not just the Ask Scott session, but all of the full episodes where I do interviews with top Amazon sellers, people starting from scratch and building a business, if you want to listen to any of those episodes, head over to theamazingseller.com and you can find all of that over there. You can also find details there on how you can ask your own question and get it aired on an upcoming Ask Scott session and possibly see it here on YouTube or just on the podcast. All right, so definitely head over to theamazingseller.com. There's tons of resources over there for you to be able to build your e-commerce and Amazon business. So definitely go check that out. Now, I just wanted to remind you one thing before I let you go. There's a lot of information out there and some of it is really, really good. What I want you to remember is you have to not just consume the information, you have to actually apply that information. So take this information that you learned here today and apply it to your business. And this way here, you can get results. As my shirt says, I wear it almost daily. Take action. We'll see you guys. We'll be right back.